AFK. AFK.
Welcome to the double damage bonus content AFK episode 2.
Number 2.
How's everybody? Dirty Joe, how are you doing? How you feeling tonight?
I'm feeling pretty cute with cat ears.
Zugare, what is your favorite soda?
Mountain Dew, probably. It's the worst soda for you.
Oh, what?
You're sick.
I can't help but be who I am.
Horde or Alliance?
Horde. Alliance doesn't have enough caffeine for my needs.
Wow.
All right. Square One, do you like B-ball?
Yes.
What about hoop ball?
Kentucky won. I'm excited.
No.
I cheered for them the entire time. Let me go more in depth about basketball. Just kidding. Kentucky won, though. Spoiler.
Spoiler, yeah, if you were going to watch that later.
Have that TiVo, dude. Come on.
Jeez. I'll
okay.
I only watch with the commercials.
You don't even own a TV.
I don't think I've ever owned a TV.
What? Wow. Really?
Yeah, seriously.
You've owned a TV.
No, I've seriously never owned a TV.
What'd you watch Star Trek on?
Fucking TV tuner.
So this is the AFK show. This is where we talk about things we do outside Dota 2, and it doesn't really make sense. It's called AFK because most of the things we talk about are on our computers.
But yeah.
Let's not worry about that. AFK away from keyboard? Wait, is that what that stands for?
Always
free
keyboards.
Anime Friends Kawaii. That's what it
means. Oh, there we go. That's
oh, yeah. Anime Friends Kawaii. Kawaii. Oh, wait. Kawaii or Kawi?
Kawaii.
Yeah,
because Kawaii is scary and Kawi is cute. So.
Ask Minxie.
Ask Minxie.
Ask Minxie or Ask Jinxie, depending on which one you want. Third Joe.
Yo.
What's going on, man?
Let me tell you about Diablo 3.
Does it blow? Does it Diablo?
Nah, it's Diablo cool.
That doesn't make sense.
Okay.
So you've been nerding out on Diablo 3.
It's been really bad.
Beta. Yeah.
I actually, to do the last podcast, I had to force myself not to start getting into the talent trees.
Of Diablo 3. Like, speaking of the new Dota 2 hero, have you guys seen the Diablo 3 talent trees?
Because that's basically how it was going. As we were putting together the show, you're like, stop looking at that and read something about Dota. And I'm like, yeah. Okay, I will do this.
But now you have free reign.
Well, but I didn't read it, so.
No.
But
they just
released
that warrior video, didn't they? Or the barbarian, I mean.
Well, right
Demon
now.
Hunter.
Demon Hunter? Really? See, I've been watching, basically, I'm going to go through and watch every class. From the beginning of, what is a beta to go to 10, level 10, I think?
13, I think is
13.
The next you can get.
So I'm watching them from 1 to 13. And actually, I've been watching them. It's getting kind of boring because I've seen the same thing, just with different characters.
Mm-hmm.
But man, I'm just so ready for this. Looking at like the barbarian skill tree, it's just like...
That's what you're going to play? You're going to play Barb?
I think I'm going to play Barb. And that's something I needed to address to you guys because we're probably going to be we're probably going to be playing it. So this might not be able to be something solved today.
We need to figure out what we're going to roll.
It's something to think about.
What are you going
to
roll?
No, let's just roll right now.
All right. Well, so I was only going Barbarian because I know Zugare wants to go Witch Doctor or Wizard.
Yeah.
And I know Ryan wants to go Demon Hunter because he likes to play girls. And I knew you were probably playing Monk.
Every class can be boy or girl.
Yeah, that's true. But Demon Hunter girls are really cute.
Hmm.
And that's where everybody seems to be playing them is like the girl.
Which one's the Wiz War class?
Wiz War? Probably Wizard.
Wizard?
Yeah, probably Demon Hunter.
Yeah.
So why were you so impressed by Barbarian over the other one?
No, I wasn't.
Oh,
I just picked him because I'm like, well, looks like I'm playing this guy.
Oh, cool. I get two swords. Awesome.
Yeah. Well, I mean, I'm trying to get into it. I mean, I'm excited about it. Yeah. I played a Barbarian and an Assassin in Diablo 2, So, I mean, I know what's going to happen. I'm going to play through it. Eventually, it's going to get to the point where, like, oh, cool, I got bigger swords. Oh, cool, I got cooler looking swords. That's kind of what I remember doing with barbarians.
Is there no ranger class?
Demon. I should probably go through this too. Barbarian.
Demon Hunter has dual crossbows.
Yeah.
Oh, so you're like, my. Pow, pow, pow.
She has, like, a rapid shot, which I was
crossbows?
Watching.
Isn't that, like, wasn't there some, like, terrible game mascot that had, like, dual crossbows? Blood Rain? Probably. Was it Blood Rain? Did she have a crossbow?
Sounds familiar.
She had dual something.
Yeah.
Anyways.
So from what I saw she has like a hate bar that's kind of like a mana bar.
Mm-hmm.
And then she has another.
Oh, I do hate everything.
Yeah, so it's going to be pretty easy to play. But it's like cut in the middle, so like you can use your hate abilities and you can use these other abilities. It was really early in the game, so I couldn't really say how in-depth it was going to get.
They should incorporate some, like, Wii controls where to fill your, like, hate meter, you need to, like, yell into your mic.
That would be awesome.
Get into the character.
Need more rage. But, yeah, it looked really cool. She had, like, a kind of, like, a blinkish ability where she can, like, you know, jump through stuff.
Mm.
So... She looked fun. They were kind of saying, like, oh, this would be really good for PvP. And I said, well, I don't care about that.
Diablo 3 PvP? Like, really?
Who cares about that?
It's not
nobody.
What Diablo is.
Nobody. So, Monk. I don't know a whole lot. Have you looked into Monk much, James?
They haven't really released much for him, but he's really exciting. He's, like, the typical, like, he has all, like, the impenetrable, like, he has, like, fist weapons. And, like, he can punch and do crippling moves and stuff like that. Just combo-based kind of.
Yeah.
The monk's looking really strong.
Monk is looking really good. I am really excited for the monk. I like monks in all games. Monk and Dungeon Defenders. Monk everywhere.
The attacks just look really, really good.
Yeah.
I watched, the Demon Hunter and Witch Doctor I watched today. The Witch Doctor seemed way stronger early as compared to the Demon Hunter. Once the Demon Hunter got the rapid shot, she was killing stuff really fast, but she was also burning through like her mana bar really fast.
She's a late game carry.
That's what I was thinking. I'm like, she looks like a lady.
She's a lot of farm.
But the Witch Doctor was awesome. He has, like, an ability that slows, like, pulls, like, hands come out of the ground and attack the creatures as they're coming towards you.
I think Jeremy's always played, like, Necromancer slash
right.
characters
like
that.
I'm a caster,
man.
I'm a caster. What can I say? He can, like, set out a wave of frogs, man.
I was watching. He was throwing out these jars, and once they exploded, spiders would come out and attack the enemies. It was awesome.
Did you know that Monk was one of the original WoW classes and they took it out? Like in the.
Really?
Or originally they were planned to have a monk.
Wow.
It's interesting. They took it out.
It only took them.
It would have been cool though.
What? How many years has it been? But yeah, and then Wizard. I don't really know much about Wizard either. I haven't got to that point. But I would assume.
CJ Wizard.
He's a wizzy dude.
He has a hat, pointy hats, yep. Fireballs, all the
stuff. Witch Doctor skill, there he lets a bunch of frogs out. You can change it so instead of a bunch of frogs, it just summons a giant frog that eats people.
Oh my god, this game is so good! Oh man, I'm so excited for
watching this. Watching the videos, though, the graphics are pretty underwhelming.
You should look at the skill trees, and then I think you're going to be a little more excited.
Yeah.
It's kind of hard. Graphics don't do it justice, because Diablo, you're moving so fast that you don't really sit and stare at anything, because you're just moving too fast.
Mm. A couple things too is the gold pickup, which is interesting, which you don't have to click on gold anymore. You just walk over it and it picks it up for you, and you can get actually gear that increases the radius of your gold pickup. So I would assume late game, like nightmare mode, probably you'll be able to just pick it up automatically,
absorb gold anywhere near you.
Right,
like a magnet.
Yeah, so that I actually am happy about.
Yeah,
it is a more casual feature, but clicking gold is annoying,
cool, man. Yeah. You click it.
I'm pretty sure
sound.
clicking gold in Diablo 2 like aged my wrist. Yeah. And was 30.
I know.
I think I broke two mice throughout like Diablo 1 and Diablo 2.
Wow.
All the gold.
Yeah, it's so repetitive, and I don't remember gold scaling. It did scale, but I just remember picking it up thinking, why am I even doing this?
Well, the problem was you had a max gold you could carry, and you maxed that out really fast, so it's just like, I'm already have all the gold, who cares?
Right.
Interesting. So are you not worried at all that Diablo 3 is made by Blizzard Entertainment?
I am still worried about that. I am still worried that they will casualize it and mainstream destroy everything. It.
Because they're going to mainstream it and they're going to casualize it a little bit, which is fine.
A little bit.
I just hope they don't go overboard.
My theory from just what I've seen is that it will be very accessible. Like, so level 24, you're only using your left and right mouse for your... You can only have two abilities active at once.
Mm-hmm.
And then once at 24, you'll get your whole skill set 1 through... six, I believe. Which, you know,
seems like kind of a long time to only have two skills, but
yeah, it does seem like you level pretty fast, I will say. And there's one other thing that probably it's going to be fairly easy. Just the normal mode. I think the normal mode will be something most people can, you know, get through it with somewhat a bit of difficulty. Then once you hit nightmare mode, that's when the more hardcore players are going to start, you know, shining.
Right. Because, I mean, in my opinion, a hack and slash, you should be dying, like, all the time.
Right.
they've already said with nightmare mode, like, once you get past hell, when you go to nightmare mode, it's going to take you weeks to even, like, be able to do anything. Like, it's really? Going to be insanely hard.
Like, you have to grind a bunch of gear and stuff?
Yeah.
That's
like,
good.
Yeah, you can't just walk in nightmare mode.
You're That's gonna, my kind of game.
Yeah.
Grinding gear. That's what I'm not I even know. Being, I'm not no, even I'm, kidding. I like
too.
That.
Me
I like
too.
That.
Me too. It's
Diablo's your game then.
No, it's our game.
It's our game.
So you're going to hear a lot more about Diablo 3 in the next few weeks, probably.
Yeah, and then once it comes out, you probably won't hear a podcast for a couple
months.
The podcast
will be over.
That's funny. But so. That's probably pretty true.
Yep.
That's cool. All so right. We are all playing Diablo 3, correct?
Sounds like it.
Yep. I'm playing it. Yep.
Who's going to be the
already,
wizard? Who will be our wizard?
I paid for my 1 year of WoW to get my free Diablo.
That's ridiculous. That's such a ridiculous tie-in.
That's one reason I'm so angry at Blizzard, and I worry about this game. But
why?
I worry about the game because of things like that. Yeah. Like, oh, you pay for a year of WoW, of all games, the most casualized game ever. You pay a year for it for what they're saying is going to be a somewhat hardcore game. It just doesn't make
Have
sense.
Have they used that word?
They said you're going to die. They've said
there's hardcore mode.
Ooh.
There is hardcore mode. So
where you actually only have to die once.
And then you lose your character.
Then you don't die anymore.
Yeah.
Because you are dead.
For good.
So
I think actually in regards to that, what they're trying to do is like they're obviously losing subscribers by the month for a while, and if they do this, they can kind of transition them to Diablo, hopefully, so they can like make it their new big, you know, recurring moneymaker.
It is basically their next big game, and StarCraft 2 was big, but it doesn't seem like it had the same kind. I mean, Diablo 3 seems like it has a crossover audience with WoW, where StarCraft really didn't feel like it did.
No,
you know. Because they're very different, but Diablo.
Yeah, that's a whole different fan base.
Right.
It's definitely making money.
Where, Diablo 3 is definitely not like WoW or anything, but it has crossover appeal.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Definitely.
That's cool. That's
but
cool.
But we could talk about it forever, so.
We'll save it for another time. Hey, this is the cool transition. Zugare!
Hey!
Quit drinking that Mountain Dew.
Get off the
I was
the
trying
dude.
To make the transition as awkward as possible.
Oh, yeah?
Nice.
So, what are you doing? So, what's up? What's going on?
Soon a podcast, I guess.
Cool, podcasts are kind of dumb. They don't even have a video. Where's the video? I can't see you.
How am I supposed to watch this?
Yeah, that's a very, really boring video.
Anyways. Well, yeah, YouTube's gone downhill lately.
I guess why am I heckling myself? I don't know.
Video games.
Zugare, what have you been doing?
Playing Guild Wars.
Ooh. 1. Why would you be playing Guild Wars 1?
Because I need to have all the unlocks for Guild Wars 2. So I've been going back and trying to finish that up. I'm pretty close. Just about done. It's just a matter of doing it. But I still love Guild Wars 1.
So how big a deal is having... Like, how much impact will having all those unlocks have on your... When you do start playing Guild Wars 2? Is it...
I would say probably about 0%.
I mean, what types of bonuses are you getting? I mean, I don't even
know. It's all items, but I think it's like they're low-level items, but they have custom skins. So what you can do in Guild Wars 2 is you can give an item the skin of a different item. So in theory, I could have cool items that only cool guys like me would have the look for. And then I could pat myself on the back.
Are these things that are going to be unavailable once Guild Wars 2 comes out?
You can always go back and do it.
Oh, so you'd make it more appealing if, like, once Guild Wars 2 came out, like, you didn't have access to these anymore. And then it was like, only the cool guys from Guild Wars 1 have it.
Yeah.
This is called...
Time things are kind of cool.
This is called transmogrification in World of Warcraft.
Where you make an item look like another item?
Yeah, that's what it is.
It's in most games on release.
Yeah. Do you pay for that?
Nowadays.
I don't know. It could be a microtransaction. I don't know. Probably not, though.
Probably not. If WoW doesn't make you pay...
Oh, WoW, you do pay $15 a month. Guild Wars 2,
well,
you don't.
Yeah, that's true. So,
that's expensive transmogrification.
I could see them doing some fee or something for that. So, yeah, Guild Wars 2 is free to play, right? Same with Guild Wars 1.
Yep. So that's a nice thing. That's what, you know, I can just pop on and then do this and then not have to worry about, like, oh, I got to get this done before my sub expires. It's like, I'll just get it done whenever.
How often do you see yourself, like, playing Guild Wars 2, honestly?
Guild Wars 2? I don't know. It's hard to say. Like, I'm really excited.
How long would you see yourself playing it if Diablo 3 wasn't coming out?
That's another problem. The other problem is Guild Wars 2 is changing a lot. I mean, I'm not super worried, but it's not exactly Guild Wars 1, so I mean...
Yeah, I saw some initial impressions from some people from the beta, and they weren't too enthusiastic about it.
A lot of people are, and not everybody is. I don't know. I think my expectations... I'm trying to not really hype at all because, like, it's not going to be the Guild Wars I'm used to, so I don't know.
Why you love Guild Wars so much? I never even played Guild Wars.
Yeah, I don't know. It's just, I don't know, because the PvE, like, you can get to level 20 in, like, less than a week, and that's max level. And anything after that, like, you get max items, max armor, like, level 20. So it's just all the stuff you do is purely just to do it, pretty much, just for prestige. And I prefer that as opposed to, I don't know.
So it's basically all grind? What you're saying?
Pretty much, it's all grind, and I don't have to group with any human people. I can use all my AI guys. And,
that's what I'm talking about.
What?
I don't have to talk to a single human person.
Yeah, that is what I'm seeing from Guild Wars 2. It definitely looks a lot more MMO-y.
Mm-hmm.
Where Guild Wars was kind of its own thing.
Yeah. Did you watch the Total Biscuit video about it? Did you watch that?
Yeah, that video didn't do much for me. I don't know if it's because I don't like Total Biscuit.
It kind of hurt my impression of it.
I don't really like him either.
Well, I like him.
Don't start an internet beef.
I don't have a problem with him. It's just like his opinions aren't the same as mine, so it's hard for me to tell, you know?
Yeah. He might not like things that you actually like, so.
Yeah.
Just his... It was... I mean, because it was just pretty much a straight playthrough. He's like, I'm going here, I'm doing this, I'm doing this. Some of it just didn't seem very good. Like, a lot of it... Like, there were a lot of issues with... Like, they say they're having the events, like, the world-changing events. And he said there's a lot of issues with, like, it respawning weird and at random intervals. And so, I don't know. Watching the beta gameplay kind of hurt my impression of it.
The one thing that really piqued my interest about this game is that when I heard them do a review and they're talking about it to the developers, and they're like, if you don't choose to go protect this town from mercenaries... It'll just get overrun and killed, and it won't be any different in the future. Like, I thought that was really cool.
Mm-hmm. Right, and that's what his video was kind of debunking in him playing through it. He's like, well, it doesn't really matter if I do this or not, you know.
Could be like a beta thing, too, for testing, to be honest.
To say. Yeah.
Yeah.
I like the whole personal story thing. It's pretty cool where you get your own, like, you know, the story you have on your character can be pretty... Not super unique, but more unique than just doing the same stuff that that class always does. Whatever, that's kind of cool.
Trying to bring some Mass Effect-ish story to it or something, maybe.
Wait, that game had a story?
Yeah, a great one. My biggest pet peeve with Guild Wars 2, though, is half your skill slots are set by the item you're using.
Mm-hmm.
So, and then the other slots are like... In Guild Wars 1, you have 6 slots... Yeah, I believe it's 6. I don't know. Top of my head. I think it's 6. It might be 8. Anyways, but you can customize all those exactly how you want. You have a subclass and a main class, so like you can just there's just tons of combinations. You can just do kind of crazy builds, and it kind of sucks. Guild Wars 2 is not going to have. It'll still have some of that, just not to the extreme.
He was saying that they had like racial abilities too.
Yeah.
That were more just like which I thought was a good idea. That they're just kind of like for fun, like kind of like quirky things you could do. And he was saying that he was making it sound like they had tons and tons, kind of like what you're saying now.
Like of ability combinations?
Mm-hmm.
it's just different because each weapon has its own set of things. So if you pull a sword up, half your skills change to that sword's skills and stuff like that. So they're still there. They're just not. It's not as open. I can't customize all those slots. Like some of those.
So once you get like a weapon where you like the skills on it, do you like level it up?
I'm not exactly sure how that works. I don't know.
Interesting.
Sounds like an interesting system. At least somewhat unique. It always seems like when a new MMO comes out, they have like one unique thing that makes it not WoW.
Yeah.
You know, they have to have one thing.
Yeah. The realm versus realm PvP is interesting too, I think.
The world versus world versus world, the three-way PvP, that's where I like, that's when I determine whether I like this game or not, is how good that is.
Because Guild Wars is definitely, isn't it more PvP based than PvE?
Yeah, it's definitely a PvP game. The PvE stuff's all kind of, it was kind of added as like an afterthought.
Right.
It's PvP first. And the beauty about Guild Wars 2 is you want a PvP, you can just a max rank, max gear person from level one. Day one, you can have a max gear, max rank PvP character.
Well, yeah, it seems like they're really trying to make a balance. Basically, like, you don't need to be like raiding that 5 billion HP dragon to be able to PvP.
Yeah, well, Guild Wars 2 looks like it does have a lot more PvE in it than Guild Wars 1 did. I mean, it's a lot more centered around it, which is cool,
but
depending on how it goes. But
the downside of that, the instantly PvPing, you will have less skills than if you were to actually level your character. As you level up, you get skills, yet you can still go PvP. It's kind of like being a level 5 in WoW, and then you can do the level 80 PvP, but you're only going to have a few skills to work with.
Wait, you can do,
you know what I'm
max
saying?
Max level PvP in WoW with level 5?
I'm saying what it is.
Oh, I was like, whoa, they've changed a lot.
No. I'm saying that's what it would be like is, you know, or say you're like level 50, you have all level 50 skills, and then they just bump you to 80
right
when you're in the battleground, but you won't have all those abilities.
Right, but there is other PvP like arenas and stuff where you get everything.
Really, there are. Okay.
Yeah.
So you can just you can level just by doing PvP and still get items and loot.
You don't have to level. You literally just like you have everything to start with.
Weird. That's weird.
I also like that they have sidekicking in the game. I really like sidekicking.
What's that? We kick to the side.
It's power level.
Where you can, where basically if your friend's higher level than you, he can come to you and sidekick down, and it'll make it so he goes down to your level, so you can group together.
That would so it's not like you have a level 80 and a level 50 and you get no XP.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Stuff like that.
Exactly.
That's cool.
Yeah, that is cool. And he has his abilities. Correct?
Yeah.
So he'll have more abilities than you would at a lower level.
Uh huh.
This is cool. So
interesting. So you can get max level and then carry your girlfriend too.
Yeah. Yes, it's gonna be a lot of that.
So my final thing is, if you do want to do the Guild Wars unlocks, it's possible. It can be done, even if you've never played Guild Wars before.
Really?
It'll take you some time. Like, I don't know, probably take you a month if you really just only do that. You do it like as efficiently as possible. But I mean, I don't know if it's worth it or not. But if you're interested, it's possible.
You've tried to talk me into it, and it's definitely not going to happen.
I wouldn't say you should do it. I mean, I don't know the rewards are going to be that good.
I logged on. Jeremy wouldn't PvP me.
Oh, he's scared. He's scared.
He's scared of my PvP ranger.
I'm grinding out points for my Hall of Monuments.
Get all the monuments, man. So when is Guild Wars 2 supposed to be released?
Sometime this year, maybe.
Maybe. That doesn't sound too promising.
Probably end of the year.
Are you in the beta? No, you're not, are you?
If you pre-order next week, you get the beta.
You get in the beta instantly if you pre-order?
You get in all the the beta weekends after that.
Right.
So whenever they are.
Interesting. Well, all you guys do is play video games.
Mm-hmm.
Why, you just sit around and play video games all day?
Video games too good.
I've been doing a video game IRL. Why is everyone sleeping? Because I'm not talking about video game? So
I know what IRL means. It doesn't make sense to me.
My topic this week is a little thing called urban exploration. You guys know what that is?
That was too jinxy for me. Or I mean minxy, I'm sorry.
It was minxy. You guys don't know what that is, do you?
You have to wear hiking boots.
It's recommended.
That's where you go and try to find the most horrible looking house you can, and you go inside.
That's it in a nutshell. So basically, urban exploration is exploring the spaces around you. It's really hard to talk about without sounding like you're trying to be like a poet. But just exploring the spaces around you live that are not seen by people, typically. So abandoned buildings or subways or tunnels or just things like that in general. And I think it has gaming crossover appeal, personally. Because it does feel, if you're into like adventure games or MMOs with lots of adventuring, it does kind of give you that feeling of exploration that you don't really get typically.
Do you get loot?
No.
No loot?
Rule one is not to take anything from when you explore. Yeah, leave everything the way you found it.
Well, if you find like some cool broken glass,
You can step on it.
What if you find a homeless guy?
That is a definite possibility. Hasn't happened to me yet, but it's definitely part of it. Finding like squatters and stuff like that in abandoned buildings can definitely happen. But I think the experience you get is worth it. You get lots of XP.
So, do you go during the day or do you go at night?
And
is it more haunted at night?
Ooh, it's definitely more haunted at night. Everyone knows that. Everyone knows ghosts only come out at night.
Right, of course.
But I usually go during the day. I don't know. Because night, it's super creepy.
Well, yeah.
And
so
you need a flashlight during the day. I don't want to imagine what it would be like at night.
Yeah.
Probably still need a flashlight.
Yeah.
Probably.
But, I mean, I don't know. If you just look around where you live, if you live in any urban area, if you just kind of look around, you'll notice lots and lots of just...
So would you recommend that if I lived on Prospect, just to go explore some bad-looking houses?
Yeah, any house that looks being worn down.
Prospect, that is a typically ghetto street in Kansas City where we live. But there is actually a place on Troost, which is another really rundown area that I'm going to soon. Oh. So I ain't scared.
What's cooler, geocaching or urban exploring?
Urban exploring, man. Geocaching is... there's no exploration in that.
What if you did them both at the same time?
I'm getting bored of this outside talk. I think you might be onto something. You guys are really bad interviewers, by the way. You guys are just sitting here awkwardly
trying to understand
empty houses. It's too deep for you.
Level up.
You don't understand
how
cool it is until you do it. Is basically what
how
it
comes come the flashlight
I've done this stuff. I've done this stuff before.
Oh yeah.
I've gone to abandoned houses and just like, whoa, it's
yeah.
I mean, I haven't
houses
for a
aren't
long
that
time.
Great. I've, houses aren't that great.
There's been cool ones. I mean, like
the city,
out in the countryside.
Yeah. The city infrastructure stuff is the stuff that's really cool. Just because.
Yeah, explain you, that. I mean,
well,
more
if you,
so.
If you go to like an abandoned school or something. It's basically everything is, there's so much stuff that's left. It's not like they take everything with them.
Uh-huh.
So there'll still be stuff written on the chalkboard from like when the last class was, and lots of things will be left just like they were left. But other things are just completely trashed. I don't know. Just a really interesting mix between the present and the past kind of going on.
Yeah.
That juxtaposition is what's kind of cool.
The only thing I remember exploring was when I saw those pictures of some tour they do through like Chernobyl and the exclusion zone.
Yeah, that's I want to do that. Yeah, that's crazy that they're doing like actual tours of that now. That's like the ultimate of urban exploring would be doing something like that. Just an entire city abandoned. Kind of insane.
Pretty crazy. I've seen a lot of similar stuff with kind of like old like amusement park sort of things.
Yeah,
I've
that's another
that
common
too.
One that people like.
Yeah.
So, yeah, if you have a creepy derelict vacant building by you, you should go walk around in it.
And we are not legally responsible for what
but
happens.
But yeah. I mean, I'm saying that like that, but it is something you have to be very cautious while you're doing. And
what happens if you get caught doing that by a cop? What if a cop's just like, hey?
Most of these properties that I'm interested in are like city owned.
Uh-huh.
So they're not really going to have like private patrols. Like some vacant, big giant vacant buildings will have private, like, you know, security because they're liable for anything that happens. Like if someone were to die in there, they'd be liable. But from what I've read, I've never been caught, but from what I've read online, for the most part, they let you go with a slap on the wrist. The worst that can happen is you have to pay a fine, but it's not like they're going to drag you off to jail. I mean, if you have like spray paint on you or something,
right,
then you can get in trouble. But for the most part, if you just explain what you're doing,
right,
and show them that you don't really have any malicious intent, you're not a vandal.
Right.
Because that's the first thing they're going to assume when they see you is you're like vandalizing, right, or squatting or doing something really bad. So
stealing chalkboards.
Stealing broken glass. So, yeah, do it. It's definitely a fun hobby, but it's definitely has its risks. But, you know, what doesn't?
Video games.
Computer games.
Computer games. Speaking of which, James, how's it going? Square One. I always call you James. I call everyone else by their
I don't think I've ever been called my in-game name in this podcast.
Square One. What's new, man? I know you haven't been walking around empty buildings. You've probably been doing something else.
No. Some friends and I bought Trine 2 and we started playing it. It's really interesting. We haven't gotten very far, but it's kind of a neat gameplay. It's like side-scroller puzzle.
Did you play the first one?
No, I did not.
I played the first one.
It was
It was fun. It was all about like the physics and like physics puzzles.
I really like the thief. She's because we have three people exactly, so we are each playing like one class as like our main, just for fun. But I really like the thief. She can grapple, shoot frost arrows. It's pretty cool.
So it's a co-op game.
Yep, co-op. You can do it solo play too, but you have to like do hero swapping, I think.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah, that's how the first Trine was. You would have all three on the map. Because
you need certain abilities to get past certain puzzles.
Right, yeah.
Is it true you can just make a box and put somebody on the box and get to every area?
Yes.
You can jump on... The thing is, like, you can levitate boxes, and then when somebody jumps on it, they lose their levitating power. But if they jump, then you can regain control, and you just can kind of, like, stair-step people up into the air.
Uh-huh. OP. Nerf.
It's pretty OP. It's a fun game, though, so it's not like you're... PvPing on a ladder to get the score or anything, so it's kind of like you can cheese it if you want to, but you're not really doing anything like worthwhile with it.
Right, where's the fun?
Interesting. How much is it?
I don't remember. It was on sale and I got it for like $7 maybe. I think it's $15 full price or something.
That's pretty cheap. And I remember the first one, what I really liked about the first Trine was the backgrounds kind of had that old school kind of hand drawn.
Yeah, the art style is really cool. I like it a lot. Yeah, that's why I like these games.
It's definitely cool, and the 2D aspect of it is a classic game lover. I really enjoyed that.
It's more. Would you say more like a kind of puzzle ish?
It's like a puzzle platformer, isn't it?
Puzzle platform side scroller.
It's pretty sweet. I've watched quite a few videos of it.
Let's do that thing. Thanks everybody for listening to the Double Damage AFK bonus content.
AFK. AFK.
AFK.